Hello and welcome to this Print Kumi Tables for Illustrator demonstration. First of all, let me say everything which I'm showing here is in alpha state, so bugs are expected. This is still a work in progress. And with that said, let's go ahead and get started. So our tables plugin aims to bring tables functionality from InDesign to Illustrator to copy the functionality as much as possible. And yeah, let's go ahead and see what we can do. So I have a new empty document right here, and underneath the object print commit menu, you'll find a new category called tables. This category can be accessed from a different place, so I'll only be showing this once right now. We'll go ahead and get started using the create button, which opens a rather simple dialog, which is used to do some basic configuration, only the body rows, columns, head and foot rows right now. And when I hit OK, let's do a really simple 4x4 table. You can see my mouse cursor changes, and I'll be brought into interactive mode, and I can now go ahead and drag a table onto my document. So let's go ahead, and you can see here I get a nice little preview. Let's release the mouse button, and I have my first rather simple table, which I can now do some configuration on. So for this reason, I'll open my new panel, which is of course called Tables. Let me drag this out, which provides the most needed functionality in a central place. And you can see here, when I select my table, some controls get enabled. And one of the most important ones is the table setup dialog. So when I click this one, the table setup dialog opens, which is rather complex. This is where I do my configuration, how the table looks and behaves. So to just demonstrate real quick what we can do, let me change the outer border color of the table, the one running around at the outside. So let's, from my drop-down menu here, I can select document colors which are available. Let's select a nice little orange, which is rather apparent, and let's make it a little bit thicker. And you can see here nothing happens. This is because we haven't done a preview yet. So we have two options. We can either do a manual preview by hitting the little preview button down here. We can also go back to the state before applying our changes, so we can go back and forth. Or we can do an auto preview. When I enable this checkbox, all changes I do in my dialog get previewed immediately. So let me show this by selecting a rather strong color here, this dark red. So you can see here in the background, the table border changes again. What also can we do? We have inside the cells, we have text frames, which have a little distance from the strokes. So when I increase this little distance, you can see here now I have a little bit more padding inside the cells. And what I also like to do is I like to set a nice background color. So I can either apply a single background color to all cells. Let me just pick my orange again here, which is really, really bright. Or I can configure an alternating pattern. So let's say I want a pattern which changes the color every other row. So I still want my orange like I had before. And let's pick another color which is not so contrasty. And let me turn down the opacity a little bit so it looks nicer. Okay. So now I have an alternating pattern which gets applied to all cells. I can do the same for the inside strokes. So these are currently black 1 point. I can go ahead and make them thicker, configure different colors, basically do the same as with the fill colors. I don't like this right now. It doesn't look too nice. So I'll go back and revert it. And I hit okay to apply my changes to my document. Let me zoom in a little bit. And we have now done some cool configuration of our table, but there's more. Of course, I can go ahead and configure each cell individually. So let's say this table looks nice, but I want the top left cell to have a different background color. So let me select the cell by selecting any part of it. It now is selected. You can see here this cell setup dialog now gets enabled. So let's open this up. It's a little bit simpler. It doesn't have too many options. Let's enable auto preview again. And let's change the background color. So we have the cell fill, which gets picked up from our table configuration and is reflected here. And I can now override this. So let's say I put a real bright magenta override here. You can see I have now overridden the color, but not the opacity. The opacity is still 50% because this is from the table setup. You can see this is overridden by looking at this little label here, which is now in cursive letters. And I can also remove this again by using the right click and using this little flyout menu, which reads remove override. And now it snaps back to what is configured in the table. And the text here reverts back to normal. Also, very much like in InDesign, I can configure the strokes for the cell. I can select here which strokes I want to configure. So clear the selection right now. And let's say we only want to configure this top stroke here. So I select this top one. You can see here now it gets updated with the color information, which is currently stored in the top stroke. And let's make it blue. So you can see here, this is applied immediately. And now we have overridden the top color, but only for this cell. What we also can do is hit OK and select multiple cells at once. So let's say we want these top right cells to have a different background color. Let's select these. And you can see when I go back to my table setup dialog, there's now this widget appears differently because we can now configure the in-between strokes, or we can configure the color, for example, for all selected cells at once. So this is how you style how your table looks. We also, of course, can resize this table. So let me just put some text in here to show you what our tools do. We have text fields in here inside each cell. And when we go ahead now and use default Illustrator tools for resizing this table, you can see this text gets stretched because this is the default behavior of Illustrator. And the strokes get stretched as well. So they are now thicker than I wanted them to be. So let's undo this and select the table again. And we have a new tool, which is called the Resize Table tool, which is used to resize either the entire table or individual rows and columns. So let's say I want to make this row a little smaller. So I can drag and drop and do it like this, or maybe like this. Or I can go ahead and apply changes to the entire table, which then get distributed evenly across all cells, like so. So this is our new tools for resizing the table at the anchor points, like so, or at every individual line, like so. What else can we do? We can also go ahead and, of course, add new rows and columns. So I can do this by using this little tool here, which is the row tool, and I can increase it by one, and you can see a new row appears down here. And automatically, the alternating background colors get applied, which we configured in the table because they are picked up again. And when I add another one, it gets this little grayish color. We can also use this to remove rows and columns from our table. So when I decrease this value, of course, I get a little warning because I'm about to delete from the table. And when I hit OK, You can see here now I can remove rows. Also, what we can do is we can merge cells together. So we can have cells which span more than one row or column. This is done by selecting the cells I want to merge and hit this little merge button up here. You can see here now the properties of the top left cell get inherited. So our top blue border still exists. And when I do the same now with these here, you will see the text content also gets merged. And this was a little nice effect here. What we did now, we just changed the row count of the entire table and the colors immediately get reapplied to reflect this. So now we don't have four rows anymore, but three, because we deleted some rows through the merging process. You can see here the colors get applied immediately. So this is a first overview of our current state. Thank you for watching.